started out just like this, me and an acoustic guitar, just two of us singing cover songs. And it was the coolest thing to me, hearing people sing back, and that's what I fell in love with, being on stage. But I finally realized that I wanted to be behind the songs. I wanted to be writing the songs that people were singing back. So I moved to Nashville 9 years ago in hopes of becoming a songwriter. Who knows if I'd ever get a record deal.
No, don't rape him.
I was fortunate enough to write some songs for some buddies of mine. And tonight I just want to play you a little clip of a couple of them and hear y'all sing them, because now I can finally say that the songs y'all are singing back, I wrote, and that is the best feeling in the world. Number one as a songwriter before killing it. I wrote this one for my buddy Thomas Rhett. Y'all help me out, sing it now.
You're shaking that money maker like a heartbreaker, like a college plane just twisting and tearing up Friday night.
Yeah.
I bet your kiss is a soul saver, my favorite flavor. When I'm out later, I never seen nothing. Gotta get me some of that.
We're gonna get us some of a good time tonight. This is unbelievable. You sound good. Keep singing with me. And also, another crazy story, y'all. When I moved to town, my first job ever was Luke Bryan's merchandise guy. Him play stages like this and dream of being up there on stage, and I get to do that now because of you. I even have my own merchandise, Hutch. Thank you so much for selling it for us, buddy. But anyway, y'all, this is one of my favorite songs I've written for anybody because of mine and Luke's relationship, and just it's one of those things, every time I hear it, I'm like, I can't believe I get to do this, and it's one of my favorites. This one's called Roller Coaster. Y'all sing it if you want.
Well,
y'all, I think in Nashville, and I'm proud to have recorded 5 songs on my latest album that I did not write. And that's 5 songs I wish I would have written, but there's one in particular that I put it last on my album for one reason, because it hit me when I heard it. I mean, it was like one of those songs that it was almost too real for me to even sing this, but it said where I was in my life as a person, as an artist, and everything. You know, I don't want to be a guy that y'all forget about in a couple years, just have a couple songs and I'm out. I want to be here a long time. I can't do that without y'all. But what I'm really trying to say is I want to be one of those remember boys, if you know what I mean.